Hello, I'm Robert from teamisle.com and I welcome you to this tutorial about how to build a landing page with a drag and drop content builder. Let's start with a quick demo. Here is an example of the kind of page that you can create in any of your themes with a drag and drop content builder plugin. There is no sidebar and you can see a full width hero section. Multi-column layout, columns of different widths, custom headings and a fully responsive structure. We're going to use two plugins to make all that happen. The first one is the SiteOrigin Page Builder plugin, along with its additional bundle of widgets. SiteOrigin has actually been pointed out as the best free solution on the market in our comparison of the top drag and drop content builder plugins for WordPress. The second one is the Shortcodes Ultimate plugin. Probably the best free shortcodes plugin around. We're going to use it to add some additional cool content blocks to our previously created landing page structure. Nothing fancy here, just get them through the WordPress installer, WP admin plugins add new, or via wordpress.org. You'll find all the necessary links in the description of this video. Install and activate. Don't forget that you need not only the main SiteOrigin plugin, but also the additional widgets bundle. Start by going to the Page menu in WP Admin and clicking on Add New. Once on the Add New page screen, it's recommended you do two things. Switch the template of the page to full width. This will give you generally better effects when working on your new landing page. Landing pages usually don't need sidebars on them. Find these settings in the right sidebar. Then switch the WordPress editor to the Page Builder setting. From here, you have the option to either start building something from scratch or use one of the pre-built layouts. For the purpose of this tutorial, we are going to build a landing page in WordPress from the ground up, but I highly encourage you to check out those pre-built layouts as well and see what sort of mechanisms sit under the hood there. Each of those layouts is perfectly editable, nothing is hidden. There are two main container types in SiteOrigin, rows and widgets. Basically, to put any kind of content on your landing page, you first need to create a row and then add your content as a widget. Here's how. Okay, so to get started, you need a general idea of what you want your landing page to look like. Here's a rough structure I came up with. Since I need a good example to work with here, the purpose of this landing page will be to promote a guide on how to sew a cool beanie hat in less than 20 minutes. I need four individual rows. The main headline section, the details section, the one that features those three images, the about section and the opt-in section. The headline row is a very simple thing to do, yet it can look truly awesome. Here is how. Click the Row button in the main SiteOrigin interface, then change the layout to one column and click Insert. Now let's add a new widget. Click the Add Widget button, then switch to the Widgets bundle and select the SiteOrigin Hero widget. Click the wrench icon in the upper right corner of your new row. From there, go to the Layout section in the right sidebar and from the Row Layout dropdown, select Full Width Stretched. This will stretch the whole row, ultimately making it possible to have a full width image in the background. However, to activate the full width effect, we need a couple of more steps. First, edit the hero widget. There, add a new hero frame, click on that new frame to edit it. This is where you can put your headline. Here is mine. Right below that whole frame block, there is a section called Background. In it, you can set your full width background image. It works just like any other piece of media in WordPress. Simply click Choose Media button and upload an image from your computer. After you are done, just click the main Done button in the lower right corner. With this done, you can click the Preview button of your whole page. Here's what my landing page looks like at the moment. Cool, and that's a good start. This row is where I placed those three small images in my design, It's also the first place where we are going to use the Shortcode Ultimate plugin. Here is how I'm going to go about creating it. Start by adding a new row, just like previously, but this time I want 3 columns and I want them to be even. Then, in each one, I'm going to add a simple widget called SiteOrigin Editor. This is basically a standard editor window with all of WordPress text editing capability. What I'm going to use it for is a very simple content block, just an image and some text, like so. Next, I'm going to add some Shortcode Ultimate magic here. My goal is to make that image appear on the screen after a slight delay and using a simple animation. To make that happen, I click the Insert Shortcode button near the top of the editor screen. What you'll see is all of Shortcodes Ultimate's shortcodes. This might be a bit intimidating at first, but it's actually a very user-friendly system, and there are some really good docs available. The shortcode I'm going to use is called Animation. Feel free to experiment with the options available in that config window until you see something that you really like. There's a small live preview button at the bottom to help you. For now, however, we are going to speed things up and just use the ready-made shortcode right inside editor window. Simply place the following code around your image. The important thing to notice there is that the delay parameter is set to 1 second. Next, I create 2 more editor blocks just like this one and add similar shortcodes there. But I'm assigning different delays to them. 2 seconds for the second block and 3 seconds for the third. This will give us a nice progression. This is what my new row looks like right now. And this is what it looks like on the landing page. At this point, I should probably also mention that every widget and every row can be arranged with drag and drop. This makes things really straightforward for editing work. The About row use basically the same widget elements, SiteOrigin Editor blocks, but it has 2 columns instead of 3. So, create a new row and set it to contain 2 columns. Then, set the columns to be divided according to the golden ratio and from right to left, like so. SiteOrigin is very helpful here. The golden ratio is only one of many pre-made ratios to choose from. Feel free to experiment with the other as well. The content of these columns is pretty straightforward too. I just use it to hold 1 SiteOrigin editor widget each and some about info inside. This is our last row and actually the most important row for any landing page. It's where the call to action sits. I'm using a 3 column row and starting with the ratio set to even. However, I'll adjust the middle column right away to take up only 20% of the whole width. As you can see, SiteOrigin makes it really easy to adjust any column's width. You just need to click the current width and type in whatever value you want. Now, my columns. The first column is where I place a short piece of text that invites people to leave their email address to get the download. Just a simple widget here. The second block is also nothing fancy. I just use an arrow icon to point to the opt-in form that's going to be placed on the right. Again, done with the SiteOrigin editor widget. The third column is where the magic happens. This is where I use a widget from my email delivery plugin. That widget will take care of placing a working opt-in form right on the page and hooking it up to my email software. Check with your email provider to find out how to make this part work. In the end, this is what my final row looks like in the drag and drop landing page builder. And this is what it looks like on the landing page in WordPress. At this stage, the work is done and you can enjoy your new landing page built with some drag and drop trickery. Mine has turned out pretty nice, I think. Check it out. Thanks for watching. Check out our latest tutorials about WordPress. Please share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question through the comment section below. Help us inform you about new uploads by hitting the subscribe button right here.